as we are discussing about the nervous system of the human body, with regards of this topic we have discussed yesterday, that is about physical coordination of the human body, what is the major role formed or created or performed by the neurons, and even the structure of the neuron we have learned yesterday. And today I am going to teach you about the types of neurons. Types of neurons. As I told you yesterday that neuron is different, nerve is different. Remember, neuron is different. Neuron is a one of the part of the nerves. Nerve is the combination of neurons. Nerve is the combination of neurons. All the nerve fibers. That means the nerve fibers means axons. The nerve fibers means the axons. All the axons are bound together and covered by a sheath. That total bundle of nerve fibers is called as a nerve. The bundle of nerve fibers is called as a nerve. And each neuron or each bundle of each nerve fiber is covered by the nerve fiber, that is the axons. The axon, this is the axon. The axons of the neuron is covered by a thin sheet like structure. This is called myelin sheath. Yesterday I told you that myelin sheath. So every nerve fiber is having the myelin sheath. So this myelin sheath act as an insulator and preventing the combining of the different impulses when they are traveling in the nerve fibers. Again, I repeat that number of bundles of nerve fibers are together called as nerve, and nerve fibers are nothing but the axons, and these axons are combined together, become a bundle, and these are covered by a thin sheet like structure, cover. Okay, and when they are presented like this, it will be as I will draw the picture here. This is the, if you take this, this is the cover, and all the nerve fibers are presented here. All the nerve fibers. If you take the one of the nerve fiber like this, this is the nerve fiber. In this way, bundles of nerve fibers are presented here. Bundles of nerve fibers. And these all the bundles of nerve fibers, each one is called as an axon. And these nerve fibers are covered by a sheath, a thin sheath is called as a myelin sheath. And this myelin sheath act as an insulator and preventing the combining of all the impulses, all the nerve impulses from the nerve fibers. It prevents that myelin sheath prevents the all the impulses not to combine each other while they are traveling in the nerve. All the insulator, all these nerve fibers will be running in the nerve, and we can compare with the electric wire. The wire, the plastic one, will be as an insulator, and inside the wire fibers will be presented there. Those are all nerve fibers. Like this we can compare. So that is the importance of nerve, and these neurons are different and nerves are different. Okay, let us see types of neurons. Base region and the function. Based on the origin and function, all the neurons are classified into two types. That is, cranial neurons or cranial nerves and spinal nerves. Cranial nerves and spinal nerves. The nerves which are, or the nerve fibers which are originated from the medulla oblongata of the brain. Listen, the cranial nerves, the nerve fibers which are originated from the medulla oblongata of the brain, those are called as cranial nerves, and these are of 12 pairs. Each cranial nerve is very much important. Among these 12 pairs of the cranial nerves, the 10th pair, the 10th pair of the cranial nerve is called as vagus nerve. And this vagus nerve is very much important for controlling and coordinating of the all the important involuntary activities. All the important involuntary activities are controlled by the vagus nerve, the 10th pair of the cranial nerves. Vagus nerve. Okay, the heartbeat, the respiration, that means the breathing, digestion, whatever it is, the thinking power, whatever the activities are there, those activities which are involuntary completely, which are involuntary activities and very crucial important activities which are presented in our body, those are all controlled by vagus nerve. Especially the heartbeat is controlled by vagus nerve. It is the 10th pair of the cranial nerves. Totally how many pairs of cranial nerves are there? 12 pairs. Okay, and next one, the name is telling you. The nerves which are the nerve fibers which are originated from the spinal cord, these nerves are called as the spinal nerves, and these are of 31 pairs. Totally there are 43 pairs of nerve fibers. 43 pairs of neurons are presented here, and these 43 pairs are basically presented. 31 pairs from the spinal cord and 12 pairs from the medulla oblongata of the brain. Okay, and all the spinal nerves, that is 31 pairs, all the spinal nerves act as a motor nerves. And the 12 pairs of the cranial nerves are act as sensory nerves as well as motor nerves. Sorry, here it is not motor nerves, it is a mixed nerve. Sorry for the inconvenience. This is the mixed nerves. All the spinal nerves are act as a mixed nerves, and all the cranial nerves are act as a sensory nerves as well as the motor nerves. This is the origin, based on the origin of these nerves, cranial nerves as well as the spinal nerves. Let us see, according to the function, how many types of nerves are there? According to the function. The neurons are of three types. That is sensory neurons, motor neurons, and associated neurons. There are the three types of neurons based on the function. Based on the function, sensory neurons, motor neurons, and associated neurons. Sensory neurons, the neurons which are connected to the sensory organs. The neurons which are connected to the sensory organs. We have the five sensory organs already. We discussed that. That is eyes, ears, nose, tongue, as well as the skin. These five sensory organs will be connected with a specialized neurons called as sensory neurons. So these collect the information. These sensory neurons collect the information from the sense organs. The sensory neurons collecting information from the sense organs and send those all the information to the particular place or the particular center of the brain. Once again, I repeat. Sensory neurons collect all the information from the sense organs and carry that information to the particular center of the brain. This is the function of the sensory neurons. They are taking information from the sensory organs to the brain. And whereas the motor neurons, these carry the information from the brain. From the brain to the particular body part. It may be a muscle or a body organ. That is called as effector. As yesterday I told you this one, effector. A body organ which is receiving the information from the brain. And this information is brought to the effector from the brain by only motor nerves. Okay, and come to the next one. Associated neurons, and these are also called as interneurons. These are also called as interneurons, and these are connecting between the sensory neurons as well as the motor neurons. Suppose this is a neuron. Coming from the human eye, the sensory organ. This is the neuron, so it is a sensory neuron. It is a sensory neuron. So it is bringing the information to the brain or the spinal cord. Okay, so this is the information brought to the spinal cord or brain. In the brain or spinal cord, the associated neuron will be presented. The associated neuron, it receives the information. See, the information is carried like this, and it receives the information, and this information is taken by the motor neuron. This is the interneuron, IN means interneuron, and this is the motor neuron. So this motor neuron is connected with the effector, that means a muscle fiber. A muscle fiber, muscles. So you can understand now, see, the information is taken from the sensory organ by the sensory neuron and taken into the spinal cord. This is the spinal cord, simply you can imagine spinal cord. Or the brain, spinal cord or brain. Brain, this contains the interneuron, IN. IN means interneuron. Okay, this information is carried and transferred to the interneuron. Interneuron receives the information and brought to the motor neuron. And that is sent to the motor neuron. Motor neuron will bring the information to the muscles, that means effector of the body, muscle or body part. So this way, these three types of neurons will be working. So remember, this is a single path. It's not a double path, remember. It's a single path from the sensory neuron to associated neuron, associated neuron to motor neuron, motor neuron to the effector. This way the total neurons will be functioning. Based on their function, there are three types of neurons: sensory neurons, motor neurons, as well as the associated neuron or interneurons. Okay, now let us see the main part of this this control and coordination, that is nervous system. Completely the nervous system we are going to discuss about now. Based on that, based on the parts that are involved in the nervous system, based on the parts that are involved in the nervous system is of three types: central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, associated nervous system, autonomous nervous system, otherwise autonomous nervous system. Central nervous system, CNS, means central nervous system. Central nervous system is consisting of two parts, that is the brain and spinal cord. Central nervous system consisting of brain and spinal cord. And peripheral nervous system, peripheral nervous system is consisting of neurons, sensory, motor, and associated neurons. And autonomous nervous system is having the two types of nervous systems furtherly, that is sympathetic nervous system, NS means nervous system, okay, and parasympathetic nervous system. These are the major three different types of nervous systems are projected in our body. In that already we have discussed about the PNS, that means types of neurons already we have discussed, and we are going to discuss about the central nervous system, about brain and spinal cord. After learning the brain and spinal cord, we will move to the third nervous system, that is autonomous nervous system. Okay, understand? So let us learn about the central nervous system.